Hey, morning guys. Did you miss me? I've actually gotten a few questions about my stereo system on my 2020 Polaris General. So I'm just going to go ahead and take you through what I have, where I got it from, and how it works. And I'll even give you a little demo of it. So here we are. This is a system from Swamp Donkey Enterprises. Them right there. I'll have their link down in the description for this video so you can get online and check them out. This is a overhead unit, as you can tell. That's all they make. So I got on Swamp Donkey Enterprises and ordered it. It is a local company right out of Southern Ohio, so that was pretty cool. I live in Cambridge, Ohio. And they make custom systems for every UTV you can think of. And when I say that, I mean they make them everywhere from the old Razor 800s to the Honda Pioneers, the TRX, the Kawasaki Mules, all the way up to your Polaris Razors, your Can-Am Mavericks, so on, so on. When you get on their website, they have 7 pages of systems. That's right, 7 pages of systems. They make them for every kind of UTV. When you order them, you have your choice between two of them. Now, when you order for your model, it is custom fit for that model. So this is the box and design for the Polaris General. It varies. Some of them are, small in the front, and some of them, reach all the way to the back. It just depends on what kind of side-by-side you have. They've really done their homework on proper measurements and box making. So, it's a pretty good deal to go with. Now, when you order them, you have your choice between two different designs. The box design stays the same. But you have the choice either between the base model, which is what this one is, or you have the choice between ones that have, I believe they're called RGB lights. They're colorful lights that are in the kickers right here, and that comes with a separate switch. So if you're just, out with your buddies and you're on the trail and it's at night and you want them to light up, you can. I didn't see the point in spending that extra money for them. So basically what we got here is you got your box and it has two switches. This one is the power that turns it on and off. And this one right here is pretty cool. You get overhead lights. You can't really tell right now, but those work really well at night. Looking at the head unit, you have a magnetized weatherproof box right there with the seal and everything. It seals up pretty good. You got a JVC stereo, and I'm going to take you through the settings right here. I'm going to flip this thing on. I'm not going to play my FM stereo or anything right now. I'm in my garage. It's not going to pick up very good. So yeah, you just go through your sources. You have your Bluetooth audio, if you want to play music off your phone, your aux cable, your FM stereo, like that one right there. Turn that down. You have your AM. You got your Pandora Bluetooth. You got Spotify, and then you got your Bluetooth audio. So it'll take you through all that. I just shut it off. I'm gonna take it outside. And show you a little later just how loud it is. I'm very impressed with this. The cost of this unit was about $600, $599. And all of those units, if you were to get the one with the lights built into the kickers, they're usually $200 more for each design. I have 4 6.5-inch speakers, kickers, right here. That's what it comes with. The mounting on it is probably about as simple as you can get. Basically, what it is you see right here, I have three wood screws right there to put into this box with an L-bracket. Now, the L-bracket is basically designed for you. You can go flush up top. What I did was I mounted it up far enough to where I'm not touching my roof, but I can have as much clearance as I can. And as you can see, it does not affect my rearview mirror. It does not obstruct that view at all. You will have to take your roof off to install it like I did. And then basically, after you mount your brackets on the sides there, you sink your, it comes with self-tappers, two for each side, and you just sink that into your frame on each side. It's the same thing on the other side. And that's that, guys. It's as simple install as you can get. And then your power cord, I'll fix this later on. It's just zip tied right now. Runs all the way in the back. And I have it running down, and it goes all the way to my battery underneath the seat. The mount is very, very, very secure. I've had this bike all the way down at Rush and have not had a problem with it. And I mean, I was flying on those trails and I did not have a problem with it. It's actually pretty loud too, and that's what I'm gonna show you now. I know the side-by-side's not running, but that's pretty much what it is. Volume's only about halfway up. So yeah, works really good, guys. All right, guys. Yeah, that's pretty much what it is. Like I said, I'll go ahead and I'll put their link down in the description for you. And if you like what you see, go ahead and hit them up and see if you can get yourself a system. And if you like this video, go ahead and hit that like button, subscribe to my channel, and see y'all later. Bye, guys.